So yesterday we did really well. We got over halfway with installing the bait stations. Still got a lot to do though, but we've got to pull in our monitoring cards, the chew cards. We need to check those out and the trail cameras that we put out.
More than half of the stations have got rat activity on them. So we've only set them for about 3 days, and this is what we've got. So, all right, let's go.
The rats are bad for a variety of reasons, and no one tends to like having rats around. They eat crops, they'll raid birds' nests and eat the eggs and kill and eat the chicks. And they also have an impact on reptiles, amphibians. Basically, they just prevent other species from being able to flourish. You'll end up with a lot of rats and not very much else if you don't do anything to control them.
Samoa has, I think, about four different species of pigeon, but the manamaya is a special pigeon because it's endemic to Samoa, so it is only found in Samoa. So it's kind of their national bird, and yet it's very rare and very poorly understood.
In 2006, as part of the recovery plan for manamaya, they did a survey and the closest estimate was about 500. And we realized this number continues to diminish. Calls for an urgent need for conservation.
So we were talking to Ian and Sian at the zoo about how we could be involved more in conservation initiatives. And they said, look, we've got this project. It's Samoa, it's the national bird. Would you be interested in working with us on that? So for us, it was a no-brainer. So supplying a rodenticide and bait stations and any support was just fantastic for us. We know the damage that rats can do. We've seen what they can do to the manumia, and New Zealand looking to be predator-free in 2050 is sort of all part of that ethos, are very important to us.
So now you're hearing the call of the ma'o there. So it's a different kind of ma'o calling. That call is calling like this. Like, like that. But the manumia, woo, go up. Woo.
I think if I heard one, I would recognize it.
Yeah. This is the area for the manumia. We hear the call of the manumia when we're doing our monitoring here. Sometimes you're lucky when you hear the call.
So little is known about it. I think that they aren't exactly sure why it's so rare. You know, we've kind of started looking too late. But it is almost certainly as a result of the same threatening processes that have made so much wildlife in the Pacific and in New Zealand threatened. So invasive species, habitat loss and modifications, also some direct predation of manumia by humans. People, when they're trying to hunt pigeon in Samoa now, they're mostly hunting lupe, the Pacific pigeon, which is much more abundant and can probably sustain a harvest. But sometimes, you know, you see the silhouette of a pigeon in a tree, or you know there's a pigeon somewhere in that tree, and you shoot at the sound, then sometimes that'll be a manumia. And they are rare enough that kind of accidental bycatch can really help drive them toward extinction.
I was walking here a couple of weeks ago with a friend, and we found these shotgun cartridges lying on the ground. And even though we're supposed to be in a forest reserve, there is still hunting happening, and it's very difficult to stop because it's a cultural thing.
When I started working for Aminari in 2007, when we went out in the field, I've never seen manumia until 2013. And we spent hundreds of hours in the field, doing field work, camping for the whole week, and we come back home with nothing. It's really hard for us because the bird is very shy and timid. And so when we saw this juvenile manumia in 2013 in Savai, it was quite an important feeling for us. Manumia is still existing in Samoa and is still successfully breeding. Really need to put in a lot of effort, a lot of time working, and also a lot of resources. If we have all that, I'm pretty sure that the next 10, 20 years we'll have a slight increase, not increase, but at least that we know that we have population.
You know, imagine New Zealand losing kiwi. You know, it'd be devastating.
I'm still pinching myself that I'm here doing this, because for me this is just what conservation is all about. It's a bit surreal that we're aiming here to protect the last living relative of the dodo, which is the ultimate symbol of extinction. Saving species from extinction is what I set out to try and help do in my career many, many years ago, and I really feel that, you know, this is a way I'm really helping to do that.
Oh. Nectar.